Raymond, go, please.
Do we understand each other? 4 o'clock. I'll be waiting.
Morning, Ray.
Ray. Any luck with those golden eyelids?
Still working on it for you, mate. Right. But I'll tell you what I have got. I've got you an Apollo 13 and a Pocahontas.
You are a star, son. I'll drop off the pork chops for you now in a minute, yeah?
Brilliant.
Yeah. Problem with the motor?
No, mate. Problem with the parking tickets.
Oi!
You got friends in Hollywood?
Yeah. Me and Mr. Potato Head are like this. That's me on top there, look.
Aye.
Oh, bollocks. See, I'm not here.
What?
Lie to them two.
Oh.
I'll make it worth your while. Just do it.
Oi. Where's Santilli?
In Cancun.
Aye?
Yeah, he went this morning.
When you see him, tell him Dino and Bish are looking for him. And we're not happy.
You're not happy?
Do I look happy?
No.
You see a smile on his face? And if he knows what's good for him, he'll give us a call, right?
Whatever.
Yeah. And I'm nicking these shades as well. Yeah?
Well, now I'm having this. All right.
Yeah. Do you reckon suit me?
Yeah, that's smart, eh?
Yeah. Proper
fair
shade.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
you know what I mean? What else have we got?
It's
My Little Pony.
Cancun. I like it. It's very exotic. Something for you. Here we go, my friend. Time cop. Special edition. Van Damme has never been better.
By lunchtime the next day, we were sat in the Coyote room waiting for the sellers to turn up. Quarter past.
Plenty of time.
They were supposed to be here 45 minutes ago. It's a complete disaster.
It's not a complete disaster. I mean, the punch is out of this world. And have you tried that dip?
Don't give a damn about the cheese bloody dip. This was supposed to be about buying Elvis merchandise, and there isn't any.
Excuse me? You the fellas buying the Elvis stuff?
Yes. Yes. Come on in. Have some punch, and you simply must try the dip.
South Florida?
Yeah, it's a few hours down the road.
It's 18 hours down the road?
Oh, come on, Gary. You saw that Elvis footage, it was great. I've got a really good feeling about this guy.
The last time you said that, I ended up with a timeshare and was better starring. Call me in the morning.
It's him again, it's Forosh. He's gonna kill us when he finds out.
If Forrest is gonna kill anyone, it's gonna be you. There's no us involved in this.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Kick a man while he's down, why don't you? What's that anyway? What are you doing?
Give us it. Thank you. You saw my car, remember? I've got no money. I'm filling out a student grant form. So one day, I might just be able to go to that law school you care so much about.
Furthermore, you told a newspaper in Boston that you'd sent the film to the Royal Society in London to be examined, but we called the Royal Society and they told us they'd never received anything.
And you told Larry King you'd arranged to send the film to NASA to have them verify it, but they also told us they've never received any film and have never spoken to you about it.
Ha! Exactly. And I like your brainless bloody spanner.
It's my lawyer. You see, Mr. Gary Shuffield, he has been dealing directly with NASA, and he's not...
Not a lawyer at all, as it turns out. In fact, he's a legal clerk in a firm that makes cookies.
Baked consumables.
So, where is the original film?
Like I told you, it's with the investor who paid me to buy it.
And why can't I speak with this investor, then?
Because he's dead.
What? Yeah, right.
Do you honestly expect anyone to believe that?
Why won't you reveal the name of your cameraman, Ray? When are you going to produce the actual footage?
Yeah, when are you going to produce it?
Is this film a hoax, Mr. Santilli?
I think it's a hoax.
Oh, no, no, wait a minute. Remember the day the Earth stood still?
Well, so what?
Well, Michael Rennie fell ill.
Hi.
Oh, hello.
Thanks.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. You're in seat 57F, third row from the back. Enjoy your flight. Honestly, can you believe that? As if.
When did your say-so become so much more important than, say, my say-so?
Wagon wheel, anyone?
Oh, the jammy ones. It's my favourite.
Gary? Gary? There you are.
I'm not talking to you, Ray. In fact, I'm not even looking at you.
Where have you been?
Doing me laundry. Oh, shoes.
Sorry.
This all the mail?
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
I was hoping one of the law schools I applied to would ask us for an interview. Fat chance, eh? What?
No time to be worrying about law school. The press have found Harvey. Thanks, Gary. I'd never have done this without you.
Hey, keep your fingers crossed for me. That letter, I'm still waiting.
You don't really want to be a lawyer, do you? I mean, that's just something your mum wanted you to do, isn't it? Spending your entire life in a suit and reading other people's small print for a living. I just don't see it, Gary. I see you more in a world of breasts and lipstick and white wall tires.
And where do you think that world is, eh? Because I've never seen it. And if it does exist, it certainly wouldn't let people like me in.
Hey, that's not true.
You know something? You've always had more faith in me than I've had in myself. But then, you've always been thicker than me too, so it doesn't count for much, does it? Ray, you opened the letter.
Gary, just...
You knew they'd offered me the interview, but you couldn't let us find out because you needed me in America to get you out of this stupid mess with the cameraman.
Gary, just a minute.
So you threw the letter away.
It wasn't like that. Let me...
Oh, shut your face. Just shut up, Ray. Have you ever given a damn about me? Eh? In fact, have you ever given a damn about anyone except yourself?
Look, I'll call the college and explain what I did.
Do you not think I tried that? I've already tried that, haven't I? Eh? When they didn't hear from me, they gave the place to somebody else, Ray. I mean, it's not even losing the interview. It's letting me think I was turned down by everyone. Making me feel I was that much of a loser. And you knew how much it hurt. You're supposed to be my friend.
Look, Gary, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry too. Sorry I wasted so much time on you. Because you know what the truth is, eh? I don't even like you. Yeah, I don't like the way you use people. I don't like the way you lie to people. I don't like the way you're so wrapped up in yourself, you don't even notice how much you hurt the people who were stupid enough to trust you in the first place. Everyone, everybody here. I don't like you, Ray. And come to think of it, I don't think I ever have.
You don't mean that.
Don't I?
Just the one kebab then, is it?
It was inappropriate.
Obviously, it's not the job you left, but if you put in the hours, if you turn up early, if you're leaving late, who knows? A couple of years' time, you could be right back where you started. Gary, welcome to the world of Biscuit Promotions. It's nice to have you back. Can you just get the door on the way out, please, Gary?
Thank you. sound silly?
Dino, Bish. All right, lads?
Better now, Ray, for seeing you. How was Cancun?
Yeah, Cancun.
Oh, you know. Sunny.
Hello?
Christ, Ray! What's happened here?
Sold a few dodgy forest gum tapes to some blokes I never thought I'd see again. Tonight I saw them again. I can't go home, Gary. I don't want my nan sitting like this.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Did you nick this?
Yeah.
Fair play. Got your job back then?
Yeah. Well, a job. Don't ask.
Hey, you know your share of the money? It's still yours, you know, whether you're in or out.
Forget about the money.
Look, Gary, what I did, you know, opening your letter, I just want to say I'm really ashamed. Everything you said about me, you were right. I have used you, Gary. I didn't once think about what you wanted. I've been selfish and thoughtless and a pain in the neck. I know I have. But I didn't throw your letter away just so you'd come to America with me.
Why then?
Look at me. Look at the world that I live in. If you go to college and qualify as a lawyer, do you really think you're going to stay somewhere like this? With someone like me? I just don't know what I'd do without you, Gary. So I threw away your letter. I'm sorry.
Without me? Ray, without you, my life would be so unbelievably dull. You're the most exciting thing about me. You always have been.
Are we supposed to have sex now? Because I'll be honest with you, I'm not sure I'm up to it.
Oh. Careful.
It's a sweeping love story set against a Turkish fast food outlet in North London. Yeah, I'll send you the script. Yeah, we'll start in a month, but there's still a chance for you to invest. Yeah. All right then. Yeah, ciao. Oh my God, look at you. You look lovely. You look really, I love the hair. Beautiful. Yes, you look beautiful.
Kiss.
You having an affair?
Don't be ridiculous, Billick.
Yeah, but I thought you were supposed to stay at your mum's till Friday.
I haven't been at my mum's.
Yeah, where you been?
I went to France, Millick. Yeah, to Paris.
Do what?
To do a little, just a little TV interview, just record something for a French TV show.
About what?
About a certain alien autopsy that a group of friends just faked recently.
Sold us out.
I have not sold us out. Look at us. Look at us. We're a couple of mugs. When are we going to see that money? When are we going to see any money at all from this?
And you what? And you got some money for this?
Of course I've got money. What do you think I am, an idiot?
You got money? Well, how much then? You got money?
How
Tell
much?
Me. How much do you get?
Does it matter to you how much I
got? I want to know how much you got.
All right, I got 10 grand.
Good girl. I'm very impressed.
Thank you.
You got the cash?
Yeah, just one little thing. I spent it.
You're a slag.
She'd done what?
She'd accepted a payment of $10,000 from a cable news channel.
She taped an interview with them, telling the whole story right from the beginning.
She ratted you out?
Yeah.
Every lie, every trick, every person involved. I don't think either one of us could really believe that she'd done it, could we?
No.
I mean, we'd come so close to actually getting away with it, hadn't we?
Yep.
So what do we do?
Nothing we can do. The interview goes out 8:15 tomorrow morning. It's over, eh? For good this time.
You know something, I'm almost relieved. I don't think I could have taken much more.
I wonder where they went. Whatever it was, looking out for us.
Next morning I wake up, turn on the TV.
There it is, on every channel, in every paper, in every country round the world.
The same story. The same wretched picture.
The photo of your alien.
No.
No.
Hugh Grant.
So the French breakfast show postpones Jasmine's interview so they can run for a week with the whole Hugh Grant thing.
Yeah.
Right?
The story runs like crazy for the next 10 days or so. By Christmas, the whole world news agenda had just moved on. Nobody was interested in our alien or our little film again.
They never got back to it?
And there we were, sitting upstairs in my nan's house, with $747,000 in a pile like that.
Bigger even.
Yeah, it's probably like that.
Mm.
On my bed.